What should I be doing now? What should I be doing here? What should I be doing there?
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
The meeting with myself is so important because, I mean, when else are you going to sit down and prioritize your day? You have to take a second and just say pause and take a look at your business and decide what the most important things are. And then not only that, but what everything is, you know, like what is every little thing you need to think about and not forget about moving forward? You know, I have a schedule book that's 1 week per page. So I, you know, if I need to follow up with somebody next week or something like that, or you know, a Zoom call or something, I'm gonna put that in my schedule book. So that's what's gonna remind me to call people back or to, you know, go to this meeting or listing appointment or closing or whatever I'm doing. You know, so that's kind of how I keep track with things that are in the future. But what about today? You know, what are the most important things I need to accomplish today? So, you know, for me, it's like this ongoing list of people I need to follow up with and new leads and things of that nature. Also to-do items, you know, just things I need to do. For a new agent, you know, it's like me, my days are completely booked. You know, from the moment I wake up to go to bed, every day is completely booked. Every second of the day is calculated. Everything that I do is for a reason. Every minute is maximized to the highest extent for efficiency. I understand the trickle-down effect of certain activities. You know, it's like certain activities don't seem like much when you do them that day, but compounded over time end up being huge over the course of 6 months or a year, or 2 years or 5 years or 10 years. And so I understand what those activities are, and I'm willing to spend a lot of time on those activities, even though I get no immediate results, knowing that these are gonna be the activities that get me where I wanna be. So for a new agent that doesn't have a booked schedule, you know, it's like phone calls the whole day. You know, like any downtime, you know, should be spent trying to build your database. However you build your database, whatever your avenue of database building is, you know, you have to decide what your avenue is, what you think's most efficient. Maybe you're at the stage where you're trying a bunch of different things to figure out what avenue you want to take to build your database. But wherever you are, I think at the end of the day, it's just to stay busy all day, right? Never take a moment and say, what do I do? If you take a moment and say, what do? You need to fill that time. Let's just get on the phone. Just call people. I don't care who you call. Just call, you know, just talk to people. See what's going on. See what you can do to help them. You know, how are they doing? All that kind of stuff. You know, it only leads to positive results. You know, that's why the meeting with myself in the morning is so important, because, you know, it gives me a chance to kind of meditate, if you will, about my business, take a second to breathe, relax for a second, and really kind of get my wits under me before I really go hard. Because once I complete that list and I know what I have to do and I have that little meeting with my assistant about all that to work together as a team to accomplish the goals, then I'm back to what I have to do personally to accomplish and to conquer the day, and I'm going hard. Now I don't have to think. I don't have to think about what I'm doing. I put it all on a piece of paper at 8 o'clock in the morning. I don't have to think about, you know, okay, what should I be doing now? What should I be doing here? What should I be doing there? I know what I'm doing all day long. Now I'm just gonna go hard. I'm gonna kind of be thoughtless now. Like, I put all my thoughts on paper in the beginning. Now I can kind of relax that part and just go through the motions of absolutely, you know, crushing everything on that list. So then at 3 o'clock, it's like, let's do another meeting with ourselves to kind of reevaluate before the day is completely gone. Because a lot of people get to the end of the day and they feel like there was something they should have did, but they forgot, they can't quite put their finger on it. Now they worry about that all the way till they go to bed, and the next day they're mentally drained. Whereas at 3 or 4 o'clock, you'll sit down again and take another 5 or 10 minutes and study everything that you did, check off some boxes, and try to figure out what the top 2 or 3 or 4 things you need to do before 5 o'clock to make your day complete. Then accomplish those 3 or 4 things, then get whatever else done you want to get done. You'll never get to the total end of your list. You know, your list is always going to continue over to the next day. But what are those top 3 or 4 things that have to get done? Who did you tell that you would call back about a property, or email somebody, or you needed to check on this or check on that, or, you know, go here, do that? It's really important to do what you said you were gonna do when you said you were gonna do it. That second meeting with myself just helps me make sure I'm not forgetting anybody for the day. And it also helps me forget about real estate when I go home, where I can actually relax without worrying, did I forget something? I feel accomplished, and the next day I'm totally recharged and ready to roll.